ballad songs and snatches, and
I'll tell you. A year ago, I was a member of the Titipool Town Band. It was my job to take the cap around for contributions. While discharging this delicate office, I saw Yum Yum. Oh, we loved each other at once. But she was betrothed to her guardian, Coco, a cheap tailor. And I saw that my suit was hopeless. Overwhelmed with despair, I quitted the town. Judge of my delight, when I heard less than a month ago that Coco would be condemned to death for flirting. Well, I hurried back in the hope of finding Yum Yum at liberty to listen to my protestations.
Well, it is true, Coco was condemned to death for flirting. But he was reprieved at the last moment and raised to the exalted rank of Lord High Executioner. Under the following, a remarkable circumstance. So he decreed in words exceedingly the local fervently a week, and as done in reality, to all with me behead. And I am sure that you'll agree that he was right to so decree, and I am right and you are right and all is right and right and me.
Chief Taylor, Lord High Executioner of Titipool. Oh, Why, that's the highest rank a citizen can attain.
It is. Our logical mikado, seeing no moral difference between the dignified judge who condemns a criminal to die and the industrious mechanic who carries out the sentence, has rolled the two officers into one. And every judge is now his own executioner.
But how good of you, for I see you are a nobleman of the highest rank, to condescend to tell all this to me, a mere strolling minstrel.
Don't mention it. I am, in point of fact, a particularly haughty and exclusive person of pre-Adamite ancestral descent. You will understand this when I tell you that I can trace my ancestry back to a protoplasmal, primordial, atomic globule. Consequently, my family pride is something inconceivable. I can't help it. I was born sneering. But I struggle hard to overcome this defect. I mortify my pride continually. When all the great officers of state resigned in a body because they were too proud to serve under an ex-tailor, did I not unhesitatingly accept all their posts at once?
And the salaries attached to them, you did?
It is consequently my degrading duty to serve this upstart as First Lord of the Treasury, Lord Chief Justice, Commander-in-Chief, Lord High Admiral, Master of the Buckhounds, Groom of the Backstairs, Archbishop of Titipu, and Lord Mayor, both acting and elect, all rolled into one. And at a salary, the Poobah, pay for his services. I, a salaried minion. But I do it. It revolts me. But I do it.
And it does you credit.
But I don't stop at that. I go and dine with middle-class people on reasonable terms. I dance at cheap suburban parties for a moderate fee. I accept refreshments from any hands, however lowly. I also retail state secrets at a low figure. For instance, any further information about Yemm would come under the head of a state secret. Another insult. And I think a light one. It will not do. I'm sorry for you. You a very imperfect ablutioner. This very day from school, yum yum, will wink away and homeward come with beat of drum and the rum of drum to win the Lord High Executioner.
Yeah.
journey for a month, or nearly, learn that yum, yum. My love so dearly. The stay to Coco is to be united.
The fact appears to be as you've recited. But here he comes, equipped as duty station. He'll give you any further information.
Reception. I trust that by strict attention to duty, I shall ensure a continuance of those favors which it will ever be my study to deserve. If I should ever be called upon to act professionally, I'm happy to think that there will be no difficulty in finding plenty of people whose loss would be a distinct gain to society at large. As someday it may happen that a victim must be found, I've got a little list of society offenders who might well be underground, who never would be missed. There's the pistol and true nuisances, a right for autographs, or people who have flabby hands and irritating laughs, or children who are up in gates and for you with a flat, or people who want shake hands with you by debt. And all third persons who once would in tete-a-tete insist, may none of them be missed.
He's got them on the list, he's got them on the list, and then none of them be missed, and none of them be missed.
There's the banjo serenader and the others of his race, and the piano organist, I've got him on the list. All people who eat peppermint and puff it in your face, they never would be missed. There's the idiot who praises with enthusiastic tale, all centuries for this in every country that is ill. The lady from the provinces who dresses like a guy, who doesn't think she dances but would rather like to try. A singular anomaly, the bully unionist, I don't think he'll be missed, I'm sure he'll not be missed. discipline and crowds of private life. They'd none of them be missed, they'd none of them be missed. And apologetic statesmen of a compromising kind, such as, what's it calling? Think they evolve. And likewise, never mind. And what's his name? And Andrew, do you know who? But the task of filling up the blanks, I'd rather leave you. Well, it really doesn't matter who you put upon the list. They'd none of them be missed.
You may put them on the list, you may put them on the list, and they'll none of them be missed, they'll none of them be missed.
It seems the festivities in connection with my approaching marriage must last a week. And I should like to do it handsomely. I want to consult you as to the amount I ought to spend upon them.
Certainly. In which of my capacities? As First Lord of the Treasury, Lord Chamberlain, Attorney General, Chancellor of the Exchequer, Privy Purse, or Private Secretary?
Suppose we say as Private Secretary.
Speaking as your Private Secretary, I should say that as the city will have to pay for it. Don't stint yourself. Do it well.
Exactly! As the city will have to pay for it. That is your advice.
As Private Secretary. Of course, you will understand that as Chancellor of the Exchequer, I am bound to see that due economy is observed.
But you said just now, don't stint yourself. Do it well.
As Private Secretary.
And now you say that due economy must be observed.
As Chancellor of the Exchequer.
I see. Come over here.
Where the Chancellor can't hear us.
Now then, as my solicitor, how would you advise me to deal with this difficulty?
Was your solicitor, I should have no hesitation in saying chance it.
Thank you, I will.
And if it were not that as Lord Chief Justice, I am bound to see that the law isn't violated.
I see. Come over here,
where the Chief Justice can't hear us.
Now then, as First Lord of the Treasury,
of course, as First Lord of the Treasury, I could propose a special vote that would cover all expenses. If it were not, as Leader of the Opposition, it would be my duty to resist in tooth and nail. Or, as Paymaster General, I could so cook the accounts that as Lord High Auditor I should never discover the fraud. But then, as Archbishop of Titipool, it would be my duty to denounce my dishonesty and give myself into my own custody as First Commissioner of Police.
That's extremely awkward.
Well, I don't see that all these distinguished people couldn't be squared, but it is only right to tell you that they wouldn't be sufficiently degraded in their own estimation unless they were insulted with a very considerable bribe.
The matter should have my careful consideration. But my bride and her sisters approach. Any little compliment on your part, such as an abject grovel in a characteristic Japanese attitude, would be esteemed a favor.
No money, no grovel.
Oh,
Love your ward, Yum Yum.
Yum Yum.
Oh, I know I deserve your anger.
Anger? Not a bit, me boy. Why, I love her myself. Charming little girl, isn't she? Pretty eyes, nice hair, taking little thing altogether. Very glad to hear my opinion backed by a competent authority. Thank you very much. Goodbye. Take him away.
Can do it at all is a thing I never can, never shall understand.